rebuild a building. You can have prisoners released, but you can't bring people back out of their graves. And there are many widows and children without fathers for whom today will be a day of mixed emotions.
Well, my reaction is one of absolute delight. It's been a long time coming. And I'm tremendously, tremendously pleased that the politicians have at long last done what I've always wanted them to do, which is to get together and stay together till they found some framework, some blueprint that they could all sign. So I'm absolutely over the moon.
On the day Michael was buried, before they put the lid on his coffin, I put my hands on top of my son's hands and I said, "Goodbye, son, I'll see you in heaven." And ever since then, my whole world has changed. I'm a totally different person. For me to fulfill my part of that promise, I have to love those that murdered my son. And I do love those that murdered my son. And if I can do that, surely Christians in this country, both Catholic and Protestants, can learn to love one another, or at least like one another. That would be a start, for God's sake and for the sake of the children of this country.
The voices of three of the bereaved during the last 30 years of troubles here in Northern Ireland, on the day that an agreement was made, which the political leaders here hope will bring peace. From this special edition of Newsnight, good night.
That's Newsnight Special replaced this week's edition of The Right Stuff, which can now be seen next Friday at 7:30 here on BBC Two. And because of our earlier live news coverage, we were unable to complete the showing of A Miracle of Tears. The programme will now be shown over on BBC One at 11:45 tonight.
This Wednesday, BBC Two probes into every corner of your home. In the kitchen, Carluccio cooks up an Italian feast.
Cavatelli con le cozze is ready.
Homefront dives into the bedroom.
To create the ideal love nest for two of our viewers.
Isn't it fantastic?
Then Modern Times looks at different gardens on display in a Yorkshire housing estate.
Watching everything progress from nothing into something that's really beautiful.
Wednesday from 8 on BBC Two.
A cottage garden in a Welsh mining village and top jobs for Easter. Gardener's World in half an hour. And walking in Wales now on BBC Two, Janet Street Porter.
Well, I climbed the Brecon Beacons, passed through Llandovery and followed the River Towy north. Ahead of me lies the wild and isolated landscape of Mid Wales. I'll be climbing Plinlimmon and Cader Idris, and finally stopping for a paddle in Barmouth.
I started the Mid Wales section of the Cambrian Way in the company of the Culture Secretary, Chris Smith. He's a keen walker and had all the correct kit on, I was pleased to see.
Chris. Hello.
Janet.
Thank you for agreeing
to
walk
see
with
you.
Me.
Hey.
Hello. I'm so very pleased you're going
to
walk with me. And I'm only
I'm
sorry.
Looking forward to this.
Well, I'm very sorry it's not a mountain, because I know you're a big mountain walker and you've bagged all the Munros in Scotland. But we're going to walk up a really pretty river valley.
But the scenery is wonderful, so.
It's nice
why
and quiet.
Not?
No one's going to get through to you on the phone.
Chris and I walked along the incredibly beautiful Doithia Valley, just north of the little village of Randiamoyne.